All right, we've checked in with all three chefs at all three properties and we've seen their process and what they've been up to. But now it's time to take a final look at our culturally competent cakes. At the Fairmont Palliser in Calgary, a culturally competent cake by Arin. A beautiful all-white creation showcasing lots of different techniques. We have draped fondant at the base, we have quilted fondant that's bejeweled, and a gorgeous feather topper. Very glitzy, very glamorous, very chic. At the Fairmont Queen Elizabeth in Montreal, a culturally competent cake by Jean-Marc. A gorgeous, colorful, flaming creation. We have sugar work showcasing flames, so much color, so much excitement, marbled fondant, and a beautiful, pristine sphere. From the Fairmont Royal York Hotel in Toronto, a culturally competent cake by Tricia. We have these beautiful book tiers at the base of the cake, a globe-inspired layer, and then a double helix crashing through a glass ceiling. Super beautiful, very grand, showing a lot of technique, an incredibly beautiful, culturally competent cake. Jean-Marc, can you walk us through this gorgeous showstopper creation?
Alors aujourd'hui, on a préparé un genre de wedding cake à base de trois produits de la marque Duncan. Le brownies, le spécial chocolat et le confetti. Et là, on va réaliser le confetti en direct. Et puis après, on va faire le petit décor qui va avec le thème qu'on a choisi. On est parti du principe du drapeau. Et sur le drapeau, on a brodé un petit peu. On est allé chercher quelques autres connotations un peu plus artistiques pour arriver à faire ce qu'on va faire tout à l'heure.
Now, Tricia, please explain this beautiful creation we have in front of us.
This cake represents the type of ally called a scholar. That's why I chose to make the foundation of the cake a couple of books, because I believe that the foundation of being an ally is seeking out knowledge and information. The next tier is a globe, and that represents people from all over the world, from different cultures, coming together. The top tier has a DNA double helix going around the cake, and that represents two things. The first one, it symbolizes the unique characteristics of each individual. Second, it symbolizes that with education, diversity and inclusion can become part of our DNA. On the top of the cake, I have a glass ceiling being broken. The glass ceiling represents invisible barriers that people face, which prevents them from excelling. In this cake, the glass ceiling is being broken with the DNA.
Arin, please take us through this beautiful creation.
The inspiration that we're using for the cake is Andre Charles. Many of you know him as RuPaul. And one of the biggest reasons that we wanted to use him as an inspiration was for the fact that he represents the LGBTQ+ community for many, many years. He's an icon in the industry. And more importantly, he was one of the first to bring it into mainstream media. And for that reason, we used him as our inspiration for our cake that we're doing today.
So we really went off of RuPaul's outfits. So you'll kind of see kind of a flow from kind of top to bottom, kind of starting from the top, like some sort of like a headpiece of some sort, and then kind of flowing through to the gown. And you'll really see that flowing right through the cake.
Now, would you say that you're a competitive person?
C'est compétitif, c'est un peu mon ADN.
Now, do you think that you're gonna win?
I think end of the day, everyone that is part of this project, you know, be it us, the Royal York, or Queen Elizabeth, everyone's a winner in our eyes, but yeah, we're gonna win.
Tricia, please explain the inspiration behind this cake.
So this cake was inspired by the need to stay informed and initiate your own education, because the world is changing so fast, and it can be intimidating to learn some of the aspects of diversity and inclusion.
And now it's time for you to crown the winner. Who made the most culturally competent cake using Duncan Hines cake and brownie mixes and frostings? Have your say, vote right now.